Hey, what's up, everyone? And once again, welcome back to Sonic Generations. Last time we took on all of City Escape, getting all 10 red star rings. Just had a damn good time, because this is my favorite level in the game. And this time we're heading on to the very next level, which, I feel bad saying that City Escape is my favorite level, because this comes from my favorite Sonic game. Let's jump on in. God, that music just, it takes me back every single time. Now I want to play the game that this comes from. And I'm just gonna go ahead and tell you what this is straight away as soon as it loads so that I'm not, like, you know, keeping it from you and I can talk about it. Oh, press X multiple times to launch a faster spin dash. I actually didn't know that. I thought I could just hold it. Ladies and gentlemen, Seaside Hill. I know it doesn't really look like it. It looks more like Ocean Palace right now. But it kind of combines elements of both of them. I will gladly do that, Omochao, except I screwed it up. I believe that actually is a way to get a... Yeah, oh my god, that actually worked. I think there's a red ring on this route, is what I was gonna say. This shield is so unbelievably helpful. Here we go, getting this cannon. Oh my god, this sped up music is fantastic. Yeah, you see it down there? Oh my god, we jump so high. Because you jump really high coming out of the water anyway. And then I guess having this makes it even more impressive. Is this gonna go back down? Okay, good. I was gonna say, I don't wanna get screwed over here. There's a red star ring. I have looked these ones up, but I don't think I'm gonna be able to get them all in the first time through. They're kinda tough. Also, we are going to drown if this does not hurry up. Unless this shield prevents us from drowning, I honestly don't know. But let's get out of the water. Can we make it up there? I feel like we can. Oh, no, we can't because we can't do that out of the water. Okay. Well, we just gotta wait then. Yeah, I guess that does look like a faster spin dash, doesn't it? And we're gonna get shot at by egg pawns in the background. Oh my god, this shield is like the best thing we could have had equipped for this level. Just to be completely honest with you, there we go. It makes all these shortcuts so much easier. Because that takes us to the second red star ring. Invincibility, I will gladly take that. Wait, we need to be up there. We need to be up there. See, here I am saying that we're not gonna get all the red rings this time through, and I'm, like, remembering where they all are now. I was thinking I wasn't gonna remember. Okay, we gotta bounce off of this guy. Ooh, there we go. Bounce over here. Hello, egg pawns. Let me just take you all down real quick. No, you don't get off scot-free. I really wanna hold on to this shield, too. We can't exactly go getting hit with it. Alright, let's see. Yeah, this thing right here, this is gonna be painful, because you see this red platform? Of course, that's gonna fall when we stand on it, so... Oh my god, I screwed that up. Oh, we're fine. Whoa! We're not fine. Is that gonna come back? Please come back. Maybe we can go back up? Oh my god, we can't go back up. Well, I think we might have actually just missed out on that one, then. Which is fine, I expected to miss at least one of these red rings, but... Doesn't make it any less annoying. Ah, damn it, I'm gonna try that one more time. Yeah, we're not getting that. Okay, well, that sucks. It's annoying, too, because in order to get these red rings... Oh my god, we can just do that. Never mind. In order to get these red rings, you really have to stay on, like, one path the entire time and not fall off of it to kind of get all of them. No, you don't, egg pawn. There's the next one. You see it right there? I'll take that. Alright, and then I think we actually want to... Do we go in that cannon? I think we do go in that cannon. Let's see. This is such a confusing level when it comes to getting the red rings, and again, it looks more like Ocean Palace. Yeah, so you stand here and then roll down, and then I think this cannon? Yeah, it takes us to this middle pathway right here. And then we're underwater again, and now we're really under- look at this. Whee! Alright, so we just hold onto that, and then it eventually breaks. I think you can press A to release your grip on it early. Yeah, you can. Oh my god! That was brutal, but at least it brings us back here. Oh my god. That just completely destroyed Sonic. I mean, I guess we gotta play back through now to get that S rank, but... Damn. That was really brutal. Oh my god. Okay, Sonic, I need you to... There you go, bud. There you go. Alright, now the very last ring. Oh, here we go. You remember these rolling boulder things? Yeah, these are not from Seaside Hill. These are from Ocean Palace. So this really does incorporate elements of both, which is pretty nice. I mean, they're very similar levels. Oh god, oh god, oh god. I think right after this boost panel, or right here, right after this, jump and then jump again, and then jump, jump, getting these top ones for the last ring. All right, we actually got them all on the first run through. I'm legitimately surprised. Legitimately surprised. It costs us an S rank, secret sleuth. Let's see. Got the red star ring located in the hidden room in Seaside Hill, Act 1, and reached the goal. Yeah, and got a B rank, but that's fine. We'll go back through and we'll get that S rank. It shouldn't be too hard, it's just because of that stupid spike ball. I was not expecting to just get absolutely decimated by that thing, but I guess that's what happened. There we go, part of Seaside Hill is back. I want to play Sonic Heroes again now. Artwork 49, 50, 51, 52, and 53, and Invincible Start. I think that skill kind of speaks for itself right there. Alright, I will be right back after getting this S rank. Sonic, buddy. Go into the spin dash, dude. Jesus. Okay, that should be another S rank. Look at the orca whales in the back. I love that they get to make an appearance in this stage. And perfect bonus. Very nice. Alrighty, let's just go ahead and switch over to Modern Sonic. And as soon as that happens, let's jump on into Modern Seaside Hill. Or not. Come on, Sonic. There you go, buddy. Let's go. Wall jumps are featured in this next act. Would you like to see a tutorial? Sure, just because it was funny when we saw the last tutorial. Pretty sure we've done wall jumps before. Now it's gonna do it in slow-mo. Yeah, okay, we're gonna skip that. Think I know how those work. I got a rough idea. Alright, here we go. Seaside Hill. There's a lot of alternate pathways in Seaside Hill. That's one of the things I love about it. We only really took the one path in Classic Seaside Hill, but you could take an entire path that leads underwater from the start, and it's completely different. Here we go. Boom! Let's see. For example, we already have an alternate pathway we could take. Over here to the left or right, so I guess let's go this way. And you may have also noticed, Sonic starts this stage running just like you do in Sonic Heroes, which I think is a really, really nice detail. Very minor, but very much appreciated. And there's a red star ring. Alrighty then. Let's see if we can get the rest of them. I'm less familiar with where they are in this act. But we'll see what happens. Yeah, we will see if we can get them all! In fact, I already feel like I've missed one. Which could be a problem. Okay, maybe we don't go that way. I mean, we can. But we're now, here we go. This is the way we're looking for. Just go straight across. Okay. Oh, God! Hopefully those platforms come back, because we want to stay up as high as we can go. I really hope they do. I mean, I guess we can just boost past them if they don't. Oh, they do. They do come back. Okay, up here. And then I think... yeah, right here. We're going to wall jump, and there you go. There's the next red star ring. Eh. I'm definitely glad that I started looking these up, because it's making them a whole lot easier to grab. Alright, here we go. Or looking them up beforehand. And jump! I failed the last part of the combo, but that's fine! Here we go, do the quick step right there. God, I love this. I know what I was saying about City Escape being my favorite. Seaside Hill is pretty up there. Pretty up there. It's a beautiful stage. And there you go, there's the next ring. So let's just hop across these unsafe platforms. There we go. Hello, enemies. Pretty sure you did not appear in the original Seaside Hill, but I'll let it slide. We'll take this one up real quick. Not that we don't have enough lives to go around, you know? Feel like we don't need another one. All right, here we go. Jump across. Yeah, all right. So I'm probably going to end up replaying this level because as you'll see right here, there's multiple pathways you can take, a cart or the turtles. Let's start off with taking the cart path. And then I want to come back in and show you the turtle path, because they're so different. But both of these are elements from Seaside Hill and Ocean Palace. You remember this? The bobsled, I think they called it in Sonic Heroes? They even incorporated it here, which I love. You can boost, you can drift. It doesn't work very well, but you can drift. Oh, you can jump. And there is a red star ring on this route, so hopefully we manage to get that. Gonna want to slow down as you go around here. Slow down, Sonic. Oh, I actually don't know what the slowdown button is. And got it. Okay. Drift it. Yeah. Alright, we only have one left, and I don't remember where it is, but I guess we'll see. Oh my god, this music. This music brings me back every time. I love it. Go through these rings. Get that combo going. Okay, whoa! Okay, I guess we're wall jumping again. That platform didn't even have a wall jump panel on it, but I guess Sonic felt like wall jumping. Okay. Also, I think I've just remembered where it is. Take me up. Okay. Oh god! Oh, you're coming down. Don't like that. Are we dead? We didn't lose all our rings. I mean, alright, jump! And there it is. Okay, that's all the red star rings in both acts. Legitimately surprised we got them both, or got them all in both, first try. But I think that also happened for City Escape, didn't it? Maybe. We're not gonna make it! Yeah! Oh, that's beautiful. That is beautiful, and we boosted right past it. Even this gold ring area is very reminiscent of, I believe it's Ocean Palace. It's like right after you get chased by the big rolling rocks, and then you jump over to this little, like, altar section. Blue Comet. What is this? Got rank S in 12X. We're doing pretty decent, folks. We're doing a lot better than I was expecting to do in this playthrough, because honestly, I'm getting more S ranks in this playthrough than I ever have on my personal time. I don't know if it's because I'm being a little bit more cautious, going for the red rings, not worrying too much about speed. I don't know, but I'm definitely glad that that's happening. Also, the whale is so happy.
So I think we've pieced together more of what's happening, and it's not good. Whoa! When that thing goes through time, it tears space apart, leaving the areas empty and dead, and sticking them in this weird white limbo. When the Sonics accelerate through time, they fix space, returning color and life.
Then I guess we have to run like there's no tomorrow, or there won't be a tomorrow.
It takes a mighty foe to trap a ninja. Be on your guard, Sonic. Thank you, my friend. Beware, for I have looked into the soul of our enemy, and I saw only darkness.
Well, thanks, SBO. I sense a great darkness in that enemy. And with that, we have opened up the challenge acts for these three stages. We got artwork 54, 55, 56, 57, and 58, and Direct Jump. Not entirely sure what that one is, but we'll check it out in a little bit. I also want to point out that that cutscene that just played before we saved SBO does have a slightly alternate version if you were to finish the finish Act 1 first. So I'm going to go ahead and play that. It's basically only the beginning of it that's different. I'll play the whole thing, because why not?
So I think we've pieced together more of what's happening, and it's not good. Whoa! Through time, it tears space apart, leaving the areas empty and dead, and sticking them in this weird white limbo. When the Sonics accelerate through time, they fix space, returning color and life.
Then I guess we have to run like there's no tomorrow, or there won't be a tomorrow.
All right, before we move on, let's head back into Seaside Hill with Modern Sonic, because there's a couple of alternate pathways that I really want to show you. I know I haven't really done this for any of the other stages. In fact, there you go. There's one of them right there. I haven't really done this for any of the other stages, but I've played this stage quite a lot and tried out a bunch of them. And I just really want to show some of these off. They're really cool. Especially that little turtle, section. Plus, right at the beginning here, you know, we took the left path. We could also take the right path, which would take us down here. Or we could go up to the middle. What I'm gonna do is go down here. Screw it up almost. Go down to the beach, and then boost. And then just thread the needle right here to get off the boost, get into this cannon, and this takes us way up here. Which is right before, I believe it was the second red star ring? Yeah, the one that was right here. So that's just a pretty neat shortcut you can do. Let's see how fast or how much time we cut off when we go through this checkpoint. Yeah, 39 seconds. That's pretty impressive. If you take a look at my life count, you'll see that I died a handful more times than I care to admit. But we don't need to talk about that. That's why my time's so... Okay, I thought Sonic fell off for a second. That's why my time's so low. So if we were to take the turtle path right here, it's very reminiscent of Ocean Palace, where you actually go across all the little turtles. And there's even alternate pathways here as well. Let's go ahead and go to the right, because this looks like the more treacherous path. Hop on up and into this ring. There we go. This turtle hello, Sonic. What was that? That's like the kind of way that I've died a whole bunch. Let's go this way. Look, they even incorporate the fans from Sonic Heroes. I mean, it's not exactly the same, but... Triangle dive, look at that. I don't know, of course the stage that comes from Sonic Heroes is the one that I would have the most to say about, but... You know, whatever, no biggie. I was gonna say, this Sonic, what? Every time I go to say this turtle's swimming with a block on its back, Sonic just kills himself. And I don't understand why. What's your deal, Sonic? What's your problem? We got one more try here for you to not do that, if that is okay with you. We just want to get to the end of this level. Oh, the end of this alternate pathway. Luckily, we do get a life there. So, it's not all bad. Let's just not do the stomp and just walk. There we go, and then that takes us into this weird little, like, chasm? Would this be considered- Stop, you're going too fast. Would this be considered a chasm? I don't know. What? Where are we? Where is this? Are we done? Did we come here before? See, look at this. These stages have so many different alternate pathways, I don't even know where we are. I'm not sure I've ever seen this pathway before. And then just boost, I guess? Get across the water? Through the door? And then we're back in the inside section. Alright! Neat! That took considerably longer to get through than I care to admit. So I'm just not gonna admit how long it took. But it took a while. I'll say that much. Alright, Ayomo Chow, let's see. What is this, this weird named skill that we got that I don't remember the name of now? Yeah, Smasher Bonus. I don't even remember what that one is. Direct Jump. Increases the speed of your wall jumps. I don't think that's super useful. I really don't. What was Smasher Bonus again? Breaking enemies fills the boost gauge. I feel like it already does that, and that skill maybe just does it more. I don't know. And then as for Classic Sonic... I'm pretty sure his was, like, super obvious what it was. But let's see. Just to be sure. Let's see. Oh, Breath Holder. I don't think that's the new one, but that is a thing that we have. Invincible Start. Start the stage with temporary invincibility. Yeah. That's about what I thought. Alright. And then, of course, to end off today's episode, we're gonna go look at our artwork. And I guess also characters, because Espio should be in here now. There he is. Espio is a chameleon who is a master of ninjutsu, a skilled ninja who thrives on danger. He uses stealth and speed to fool his enemies. His wariness and soulful character make him a vital member of the Chaotix Detective Agency. Heck yeah. Also, I'm getting a scam-likely phone call right now. Alright. Let's take a look at our artwork. We got a whole bunch of it. Crisis City once again. Oh my god, these are so cool. These are really cool. It's just all Crisis City. Was this- are we still in the new stuff? We are. Oh my god, there's a lot for Crisis City. Look at that! God, I love concept art. Look at it! It's pretty! Is that it? Oh no, there's two more. Okay, there's one, and then another one that's relatively similar. We got a whole bunch of this artwork now, which I'm super happy about. I've never unlocked it all, so it's really nice to see it all. And then, of course, heading down into our statue room here, we're gonna go ahead and enter four more, I think. We're going to do 3-6-0-0-3-1 for Egg Robo. And then we're going to do 6-4-0-4-5-6 for Cop Speeder. Yes, that is just a police officer. We're going to do 5-3-0-7-4-1 to give us Spinner, my favorite member of the League of Villains. And then we're going to do 6-6-8-2-5-0 for Gun Hunter. All right, there we go. We're getting into the Sonic Adventure 2 enemies now. Here we go. Egg Robo. Well, you're not from Sonic Adventure 2, but you know what I mean. There's Egg Robo. There's Cop Speeder. It's a weird little robot, man. All right. There's Spinner. We just fought a whole bunch of those. And then we have Gun Hunter. Very menacing looking. I do find it a little bit annoying that the only enemies from Sonic Heroes are the Egg Pawns. They don't include, like, Egg Flappers or even, like... what's another one? Why can I not think of any more? The Egg Cameron, the Egg Hammer, the E2000, something like that. I don't know, just including something more than Egg Pawns would have been nice, but I think Seaside Hill still got a heck of a lot of love in this game, so I'm pretty happy with it. Anyway, folks, if you haven't gathered, that is going to go ahead and do it for this episode of Sonic Generations. I almost said Heroes. Next time, we're going to be heading back to Speed Highway. And we're going to be taking on all 10 of the challenge gates here with Classic and Modern Sonic. So, if you guys... I know about the boss gate key. Don't worry. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like. And, of course, let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Because, of course, as you can see, we got another boss gate to open. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.